So here's a problem that happens pretty often. Say you want to access your iCloud.com account but on somebody else's computer. Easy enough, you just use their web browser, go to iCloud.com, and you can access your email, you can access calendars, reminders, all sorts of things. But what if their computer is an iPad or an iPhone? Then if you try to go to iCloud.com, you get this. A screen telling you to set up iCloud on this device. This also happens if, say, you want to access a special function of iCloud.com on your iPad or iPhone, something you can't access any other way. There's certain preferences and settings and like rules in mail and things like that that you can only get at iCloud.com. But you try to go there on your iPad or iPhone, you can't seem to do it. It always redirects you to this page. But there's a trick that allows you to go to regular iCloud.com using an iPad or iPhone. So what you need to do is when you're at this screen, you hit the action button or the share button, which is the box with the up arrow in it. It's at the top of the screen here on the iPad. On the iPhone, it's at the bottom of the screen. Look around, you'll find it. And then you get all these different commands and things that you can do. The bottom list of buttons includes one, usually all the way to the right, called Request Desktop Site. What you need to do is tap that and it will change it so that it loads the page as you normally would load it on a computer. So now you just need to enter your Apple ID and your password, and then you can sign in just as you would on a desktop computer. And you can see all your stuff there. This is very useful for checking your email. It's very useful for looking at reminders, looking at notes, even photos works really well in calendar. But it's not maybe so useful for looking at documents or at least editing documents and pages, numbers, and keynotes because you don't have a keyboard or a trackpad or a mouse. But it'll work. So you can use all these different things, even Find My iPhone, and of course your iCloud settings. So it's a great way to access this stuff on an iPad or iPhone that you normally wouldn't be able to do because it seems to not let you go to iCloud.com in the Safari browser on those devices. So one more thing. When you are done, you want to make sure you sign out, because if you're using somebody else's device, then you want to make sure you're signed out. Now if you're doing this on your own iPad, then it's not so important.